trail 38. A little bar smacker back there, but luckily it didn't throw me off course. That was on like a little exposed section too. bit of rocks right there. Yeah, guys, so this is the Willow Creek Trails, Trail 38, Penny Pines, Mendocino National Forest. Honestly, I've never been on this trail. It's black diamond. I don't really know what to expect. So far, it's not disappointing. Couple of steep sections already. Let's see what this sign says. Willow Creek Trail. Trail 38, heck yeah, Willow Creek. Mind you guys, I'm not the fastest going downhill, especially in a, we're on a trail that I've never been on before. So this is my first time on this trail, so we're just taking it easy, trying not to get carried away. This is probably one of the hardest trails out here at Penny Pines. It's one of the longest black diamonds you can find in Mendocino National Forest, 38. They call it Willow Creek. It's out here at Penny Pines. So far it's been pretty cool. We just went on one section a little bit back. That was pretty difficult. Right now it's a little more open and flowy. I haven't really come across anything really too steep yet, but we'll see. I'm sure there's going to be something on here that's going to be steep as all hell. And it seems like every time I ride a black diamond trail, I always eat shit, so we'll see how that goes. Hoping that ain't the case, but... you never know when it's, you know, new to you trail. A lot of changes and variation of the terrain. You know, there's some water back there, and then it goes to like almost some sandy dirt looking stuff, and then some loose rocks and gravel, and then some real dry dirt. Today that this whole trail is cleared through. Every time I've tried to ride 38, there's always been some kind of down tree or something where I couldn't get on the trail. But I think since the sawmill enduro, they might have cleared this out. I mean, so far far so good. We haven't had to come across any downed trees or anything. It's always a possibility when you're out here riding penny pines. You know, fire damage over the recent years has really took a toll on the area. Ooh. Here we go. Here's some nasty rain ruts coming up. Should have took the left line here. Hopefully this isn't too swampy. Nah, we're good. Actually, we're not good. My axle bottomed out. Yeah, my chain is rocking to my axle bottom out in this rain rut. All right, so we've already encountered our first challenge on trail 38, or at least our first obstacle where we got stuck. I was concerned it was going to be too muddy and it would dig in, but it's actually too deep and my axle is stuck. Ugh. All right, we should be able to get out of that. The correct line I should have took here, took the left line and then came around this way, but I was worried about this being too soft, so I guess it actually would have been the right line over this, but oh well. So hopefully there aren't too many of these. If there's a lot of these, then it's gonna be a real long day. We're only 2.4 miles in on, I think, what, 14 point something mile Black Diamond Trail. Oh shit. Come on, 500, let's go. Let's get out of this fucking mud pit here. Luckily, I'm not a fast rider. You know, could you imagine taking that thing at speed and then getting stuck there? You'd probably go for a loop, fly over the board or something. So it looks like we're gonna come down this, cross some terrain up there, and then go up a big old hill. It looks like we got some hill climbs coming up. I'm sure that hill off in the distance is still part of Trail 38. What'll make it even more interesting today is the dirt is very dry, very slick. That always makes it fun and interesting when you're climbing hills. Yeah, this looks like it's gonna be a steep little climb here. Thank you. going downhill now. Back down. You know, so far we haven't really encountered anything too steep, but I don't know if you can tell from the camera, but looking off in the distance, there's a hill line and it's going, and I'm pretty sure that's still gonna be part of the Willow Creek Trail. That might be pretty steep. So far the only thing that's got us hung up was that little rain rut mud put thing where the axle bottomed out, but there hasn't been anything we haven't been able to make it up yet, but like I said, we're only 4 miles in. There's still 10 miles of this trail left. And I mean, I doubt it's a black diamond just for one little mud pit, so there's probably gonna be something pretty challenging coming up. This little section, jeez, this ain't as steep as all hell. Real loose too. I could probably make it up this, no problem, but. Come on, ugh. Coming down it looks pretty gnarly. Then again, going up this might be one hell of a challenge too. That was one hell of an obstacle right there. Mind you guys, we're taking the trail at a counterclockwise direction. So if you're going, if you're doing the trail clockwise, that little climb right there, that thing looked pretty nasty. Shit. Oh. My bad. Oh, bruh. Just ripped my gloves. Bummer. All right, well, Trail 38 just claimed a pair of fox gloves. I'm not even sure what happened there. I was trying to downshift. And then it's just so slippery, I just slid out right there. shit, here's another steep descent. These probably wouldn't be so bad if it wasn't so loose today. About 4.5 miles in, like we're not really making that great of progress down this thing. That's a nasty rut too. We might get stuck in this one. Oh, not good. Luckily the axle didn't bottom out in that one. Another steep little downhill section. I wonder if this is where the creek crosses through. We're down at the bottom of the trail now, so now we're gonna have to start climbing out of here. This is probably the actual creek section of the trail. Probably gets a lot more water in the winter time. Looks like we're gonna have to start climbing out of the Willow Creek area itself, but I'm going so slow and the bike's so vibey today that my hands are going numb. Just give me a sec. Looks like we're gonna take a gnarly little climb out of here and then keep on going. All right, take a drink of water real quick. Yeah, so we're only 5.1 miles in, which is just a little over a third of the trail. Slippery. so far it's been a pretty little badass trail. Definitely challenging. Riding trails like this definitely makes me want to invest in some rubber mounted handlebar mounts. I mean, I have such a good time, like I have a blast riding tight trails like these, but the vibes from the 500, it makes your hands go numb, and then it gets kind of hard to work the controls, you know, especially if you're trying to move at a good pace. You can't really work the clutch and the brake and the throttle like how you would want to. Nice little tight one. Yeah, my hands are definitely numb right now. Six and a half miles in. Take a quick break here. Looks like the trail, there's a road that intersects the trail. We'll take a quick break. Like part of the trail turned into a little forest road real quick, and then we're gonna jump back onto 38 a little bit up the road. I think it's like 17 and 34 or something. back to the trail. Trees, it's shaded. Dirt's still pretty decent, it's not real slippery or anything. Like, it's not overexposed to the sun. It's pretty nice right here. Nice and flowy too. Say 38. Yeah, see, I think that'll take you. Yeah, weird. That's a hell of a place to make a turn there. Jeez. know, this section of trail is freaking badass, man. I wish the whole trail was like this. This is awesome. Give my hands a break for a sec, then we'll continue on 38 right here. Brakes were seized up. I changed the chain and sprockets last week, and then I guess when I pushed the brake pad back in the piston and stuff, I guess it froze up, like it hung up, got a little crooked. So when I reinstalled the wheel last week and pumped up the brakes, I didn't realize it till I got out on the trails last week that the pad was froze up, and so I was stomping the rear brake and I had no brakes whatsoever. So this week I put new brake pads on, got some EBC pads and stuff, and changed out the brake fluid and stuff, but I didn't change the rotor. I should change rotor, because coming down that hill right now, the rear's real squeaky. The brakes are real squeaky in the back now. So I guess that's something we're gonna have to do for later day. But look at this. Look at this here. What do you call this? Look at this fuckery. Thank you. That was hella lame. Man. Okay, that sucked ass. It's a good thing you guys were all here to witness this. Shit. The struggles of riding a dirt bike. I thought I was just gonna hit that and then go and then ride off into the sunset, but Mother Nature had other plans for me. That was a sinkhole. It was deceptively muddier than I thought it was. And now we're in some shit. Alrighty. switchback. I guess it's like a switchback. But a nice little turn across a little creek, and then you gotta make like a 90 degree turn to go uphill. Alright guys, so this is right where we started trail 38. So we just did the entire loop. My speedo is saying 13.5 miles. I swear the trail map said it was somewhere around 14.1 or 14 point something. I'll have to go look it up, but there you have it. That's the Willow Creek Trail. That was the complete loop. Pretty badass trail. There's some difficult sections. I just did it the counterclockwise way, and that was pretty fun. I would think if you're gonna go clockwise, there's gonna be a couple of like nasty loose climbs over there where the dirt was exposed and it was real slippery. And there were some big old rain ruts coming down the center. And so there's a couple of climbs out that way. We came down them, and because we went counterclockwise, and that was probably the better choice in my decision for being my first time on the trail. I've never been on this trail before, so I think if you've never been on it, go counterclockwise. I'll look up the map and then see what fire road comes to this section. You can start right here, and then you can get a feel from watching my video what the trail is going to be like. There was a couple of little mud pits that got me. One really kicked my ass, and it took me almost 30 minutes to get over that little obstacle. But yeah, so trail 38, Willow Creek, Penny Pines. Riding with Dom. See you in the next one. Yeah, boy.